Now, let's go over a couple of neurophysiologic systems to understand narcolepsy. On the left side is depicted the arousal system, the part of the system of your brain which is keeping you awake right now. What is that innervated by? Well, acetylcholine, histamine, dopamine, norepinephrine, serotonin, all of these occur in an ascending pathway all the way to the cortex to keep us awake. That's the waking system. You'll see something like a hypocretin, right? Hypocretin is synonymous with orexin. These are two different labs that describe this same neurotransmitter system separately, called it different names. Same thing. Hypocretins, orexin, same thing. The hypocretin system in the hypothalamus is responsible for not just keeping people awake, but it's also responsible for something very important, and that is to keep people awake and make sure they don't fall asleep. Now, why is that important? Let's go to the next diagram on the right side. That's the sleep system. The most important part of that whole sleep system is the VLPO, the ventrolateral preoptic nucleus. That contains GABA. You're all familiar with GABA, right? Gamma-aminobutyric acid, inhibitory neurotransmitter of the brain. Well, that's the system that puts us and keeps us asleep. These two systems, these two brains, are basically in balance with one another, the sleep system and the wake system. The orexins, those hypocretins, make sure that when the sleep system is winning, it stays that way. And they also make sure when you're awake, you stay that way. If the orexins are not there, what happens? Go back and forth and back and forth. And that's what narcolepsy is. It's a system of a lack of orexins. So during the day, when you're supposed to be awake, you're going back and forth into sleep. At night, when you're supposed to be asleep, you're going back and forth into wake. So there is not that demarcation between sleep and wakefulness. So what happens during the day if you're sleepy? Well, you fall asleep, but you also go into REM sleep during the day. REM is when you're paralyzed. REM is so that you develop cataplexy. REM is where you see things, hallucinate. That's normal during REM. But if you do it during the day, or during the time when you're partially asleep, not fully asleep, you develop hypnagogic hallucinations. So it's an imbalance between sleep and wake. The demarcation is lost between these two because of the lack of the orexin hypocretin signaling.